Hello one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play No Man's Sky with me, EkkiThump. Here we are back again once again on Nibelheim. This time around our mission is to go and find some nanite clusters from the abandoned structures on this world, and I think we're going to take the Nomad out for a spin. But unfortunately, to do that I have to install the upgraded signal booster on this as well. So I've just made one of the parts for it. We need Heridium. And we need bypass chips, we need Karite sheets. So I'm just checking how much Heridium we've got. Not that much. Let's just check everywhere, make sure there's none hidden in the wrong box. There is not. Well, let's see. We can put a booster in, though. That's ridiculous. We are 3 Heridium off. Can I make some Karite sheets and put them in here? I can. So all I actually need is a tiny touch of Heridium. Well, where are we going to find some of that then? Let's go out and see, shall we? Here we go, here's some Heridium. Let's get up to the top of this. Grab as much as we can. Well, 4 stacks, considering we only actually needed 3, but not 3 stacks, 3 actual units. That seems like enough to me. So let's drop the Nomad down anywhere there's room for it. Get that in there, and now we should be able to point ourselves at one of these abandoned buildings. Scan for depot, scan for abandoned structure. Let's go get some nanites. Oh, now that was a stunt jump. And another. Come on. Oh, this is such a machine. It's actually pretty good. Pretty good. It definitely feels a lot more agile than the Roma. Just doesn't have the cargo space. But it just hops along. It looks a bit like a waterboatman, one of those insects. And it hops along like a crazy, crazy frog. Splatters itself on trees just now and then. You can get some really long airtime out of it if you hop and then, if you're going uphill and then you hop and then accelerate. Oh, nice. Oh, fuck. I saw that too late to do anything about it. These perfectly conical hill, which was made to do this on. Extreme Nomad Aeronautics. And we're here. Jesus, that's a big herd of whatever those are. No, oh, never mind. I'm not all that bothered about it. Okay, so that's new. Or maybe it's not new, I've just never noticed it before. Okay, where do I get the nanite clusters? Yeah, we've seen this one. It's the one that follows us from world to world, stopping us sleeping. Do I just get nanite clusters from triggering the terminal? Hmm. Quite a few as well. In fact, 38 plus... Maybe I want to get one more just to be sure. We've got some nanite clusters in storage. Not depots, abandoned structures. Here we go. Extreme airtime. Refuel, can do. There's a question mark over here. Let's see what we've got. Oh, depot. Well, let's tag it up and, excuse me. Right, grab all of these. Trigger this. What the fuck? Get out of my face! Is there anything here? Was it just Armadium? Just Armadium. Which we don't need to worry about too much. Continue on. Well, this isn't the target, but it looks like we found some kind of outpost. Ethereal Moor. Oh, look, it's a factory. This is where we could have tried the. Could have tried the Geo Baby's cannon on the door if we brought it with us. Right. Anything we can grab out here first of all? No. All empty. All empty. Let me in, let me in. There we go. One of these days that's not going to work and I'm going to die. They'll do a sneaky patch on it. And, like, not tell anyone. Okay, right. An animated guild blob is on screen waving a gun. It talks in the language of the warriors, but brightly and happily. It springs happily between bloodied runes, then asks for a donation of units. Grah! Education blob! Janzui Viking IJ Luxama units from education. I don't know what you're asking me, but have 100 units. The educational program teaches me some of the language of the warriors. Closer, treasure, city. Okay, that's not what I was expecting out of a factory, but I'll take it. What's this? Oh, extract nanites. A few more nanites, but let's go to the next abandoned building anyway. No, didn't make it. Oh, there we go. I see another knowledge stone. Unsuspecting. You know, we should really know most of the Viking language by now. Bet we don't. Oh, you know what? Now, let's go on to the next building anyway. I was going to say, we definitely have enough nanites for the quest now, but let's go to the building anyway. Damn it. I thought we cleared that tree. No such luck. So, do we have a question mark before or after the abandoned building? Looks like they're very close together. Nah, buildings first. Shit, man, we've had to refuel twice on this journey. Sure does burn plutonium. Oh! It's the same question mark, that's why they're so close together. That's the waypoint for this abandoned building. Okay, that makes sense. Lot of loot. Did we only get one bit of loot? Nah, we got a convergence cube and something else. Anything. Nothing that I can make out. Okay, let's see what's this. What this is all about then. This is the pus terminal. We've seen that before, definitely. Nanite clusters, excellent. Okay. We've got enough now, so let's head back to base. This is obviously still part of Brother Sparks' mission. I don't know what he wanted the nanite clusters for. I can't remember. Does it say actually in the log? No, just says it's a task, doesn't say what we get for it. Oh, please, give me WASD controls for the vehicles, come on. That's what I want to see next time round. Just No Man's Sky 1.4, the strafing update. Oh? Well. Yeah, I think we might be stuck up here. Never mind. Okay, we're doing a sewer level. God, this thing is unstoppable underground. Just absolutely blasts through everything. I can't see for the life of me where I'm actually going. It's just a constant cloud of stone and dust. Oh, we found an exit. Oh, hang on. Just a minute. Just saw this out the corner of my eye as I was blasting past. It's good to be able to actually go out and wander the world, like at ground level, and see, just sort of see random things going by. Because in the old days of like exploring strange new worlds in the starship, you would just sort of blow past everything. We only really saw what was clustered around colony stations and such like. Whereas with this, we get to find all the little things that are scattered around in the wilderness. And we got back just as some guests were leaving, never mind. Storm clearing. Oh. Right, right. There you go. Perfect parking, perfect parking. Blimey. That's a ship and a half, mate, that is. Let's have a look at it. Class B Explorer, plus 20% hyperdrive range. We should think about looking out for that kind of thing when we're ready to move towards the core. Nanites. No, they're in one of these. No? Somewhere. Come on. There you go. Grass box, how's it going? Alright, the acceleration module upgrade, that's what we're doing this for. I have the clusters. Yes! Take this Exocraft acceleration module blueprint and prepare, traveller. Not bad, 2 carite sheets and some heridium. We can probably knock one of those up now. Let's sell off some stuff. Let's actually do another round on the loop farm. I imagine that's regrown by now. Oh, no, hold on. Lovely Mordite. Right, we're selling these cubes and nothing else, I don't think. So now we craft the lube. Sell that. Put the spare Mordite in storage wherever it goes. We've got some spare Mordite somewhere. Jesus Christ. This fucking storage bay. Right. So stick that there. Let's put another acceleration module in the Nomad. Which requires just 2 kerite sheets. Guess I'll just have to go here. Oh. Right, so that's that installed. Now, what do we actually need that for, Mr. Brother, rather, Sparks? What you got me building the acceleration module for, eh? What are these trials? Traveller, my work is complete. I have overridden the ley lines, charged their holy data. They have revealed to me a monolith, a tomb for the final prophecy. Go, Traveller, go and claim its secret. Okay, charge the ley line. I'll speed there now. I envy you, Traveller, to see the words of Gnarl itself. Grah! Alrighty, right. Time critical event, 15 minutes to get to the marked destination and deactivate the console. Let's do it! I am sensing a bit of an upgrade. Holy shit, that is a real upgrade when you're jumping off the hills. Alright, quick pit stop, quick pit stop, quick pit stop. And go! No time for loot. We're gonna have to leave that there. It's a time critical event. Fuel. Gotta get the fuel in there. We're doing pretty well though. I don't think we needed this 15 minute timer. We're gonna make it in. I bet we can make it in 10 minutes. So if we make it there with like 5 minutes left on the clock. We're skipping so much loot. The loot hoarder inside me is just screaming at this, but I'm just forcing myself to go as fast as we can. It's always the same though, isn't it? In any sort of game. Be it No Man's Sky or Path of Exile, or any game that has loot. If it drops, I want it. But I'm against the clock. And we could probably afford to faff around, but you never know. So, no faff, just floor it. I think we're definitely in with a shout of making it within 10 minutes. 9:45 left on the clock. Monolith at this speed is 3 minutes 13 seconds away. As long as we manage to dodge those sneaky little emerald caves. Like that one there, which we just missed, with a superlative display of skill, we should be alright. And what performance from the hoverpads, what performance, completely just skipping that entire mountain valley. We are practically flying. Damn it, trees. Oh, no, 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 not the down the pit. We did it all the way here, didn't have to stop off once to recover the vehicle from a pit. Made it all the way to the monolith. Activate the console with 7 minutes and 5 seconds left on the clock. You approach the monolith. You are engulfed in its terrible truth. You see its words in the text of 1,000 tongues in the ephemera of countless stars. You witness events that occurred millennia before your awakening. You see two Vikeen standing before a red glow, asking it of the universe. You see a Gek and a Korvax waiting side by side before you. And before the vision ends, you see a vision of something you have not seen before. Of something that does not belong in this or any place. Of hatred, grief, despair. Of something that is yet to come. You see all this, and then it is over. The monolith has nothing more to show you. Know that I heard the word of the Atlas where Herc had heard nothing. In its rage, in its impotent jealousy, Herc struck me from the mountain and I saw the truth of what the monolith had said. That my end would be an awakening. That in this dream, nothing should perish. Or so it would be until the travellers. So it would be until the destruction of realities. Know this. The final testament of Nal. Shaken by your experience. As you go, you feel something right behind you, breathing, watching. When you turn, it is gone. Oh, wow. So, I guess our mission now is to go back and report into Sparks. I bet that's not what he was expecting. Let's grab all these words. Okay, let's leave it there for this episode then. I will obviously head back to base and get ready for next episode. But you don't need to see the drive back. So that was Let's Play Imperial Galactic Survival, this episode, whatever number it is. Do hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game. I'm not sure if this questline continues on. It sounded like this was kind of a culmination. I think there were supposed to be 3 Exocraft, so maybe he just gives us the recipe for the next one, the next Geobay. But we'll have to see when we get back to base, and that'll be for next time. So, join me then, and I will see you next time. Oh my god. I did not know this was a thing. Look at this. The Nomad can skim. Oh, we are so taking one of these to the next Rigogen planet we go to. I did say it looked like a water boatman, didn't I? It actually is a water boatman. It can skim on the surface of the water. Oh, maybe the third one's like a submarine or something. I know I've already done the ending for this video, but I just had to show you that. I was not expecting that at all. Anyway, once again, join me next time for the next episode of Let's Play No Man's Sky. And see you then. And I promise this is actually the end of the video this time.